Welcome back to MedComplete Board Review. Today we have a 22-year-old male who has no past medical history who presents to you after having sex without the use of a condom. The patient has sex with men and states he has had 4 sexual partners in the past 3 months in which his condom use was inconsistent. He denies any symptoms now. He undergoes testing for sexually transmitted diseases, including HIV, which come back negative. In addition to condom use, which of the following will further reduce this patient from contracting HIV in the future? Hey everyone, welcome back to MedComplete Board Review. So the answer to the previous question we posted regarding our 22-year-old male who has multiple sexual partners and inconsistent condom use is B. You should give him tenofovir and emtricitabine to take once daily. So this is a topic that's going to definitely come up on your exam, and it's something you will definitely encounter in real life. Pre-exposure prophylaxis for HIV is very, very important. Worldwide, there are 2 million new HIV infections that occur every year, and those 2 million infections are preventable. Okay, so this medication and pre-exposure prophylaxis is extremely effective. It reduces risk of transmission by 95%. So simply by just taking this pill once a day, the risk of transmission is that much lower. So for the exam, you want to know a couple of things. You want to know when is pre-exposure prophylaxis indicated, and what are the certain things I have to look for. And we're definitely going to do more questions on this topic. But the reason this gentleman is a candidate for it is because he has multiple sexual partners and he does not use condoms consistently. So he's considered high risk for transmission. Okay, so giving him pre-exposure prophylaxis 1 hour before, this is something that was talked about, which is like point of kind of like you can think of it as taking it if you can predict the sexual encounter, you can take it right before. You can consider this, but it's not as effective as taking it daily because generally speaking, people don't always know when they're going to have sex. So we recommend for them to take it once a day. And the more they're compliant with it, the lower the risk of transmission. Okay. Taking it after sex, again, this is something that was hypothesized, and it's definitely not as effective as taking it just once daily. Okay. Tenofovir, emtricitabine, and dolutegravir, this is a combination for post-exposure prophylaxis, and this is something we will discuss in a separate question, but essentially, like if they give you an exam question where a nurse got stuck by a needle or a physician and like the person is HIV positive or we're not sure the status, this is something you can give the patient to reduce their risk of getting HIV from that needle stick injury. Or you can even use it for sexual encounters in which the patient does not know the HIV status of the person they had sex with, okay? But we will discuss this separately in a different question. Trimethoprim sulfamethoxide or Bactrim, this is used for PCP prophylaxis in patients that have HIV once their CD4 count drops below 200. Also high yield for the exam, but it's not appropriate for our patient because our patient's HIV negative. One thing you want to know, guys, is when you give these patients PrEP, it's very important that they should be monitored closely. Again, we're giving them this because we consider them high risk. So these individuals have to come in every 3 months. They need to get HIV testing, STD testing, and they also need to get their renal function checked because tenofovir emtricitabine can cause acute kidney injury and it's contraindicated once the GFR drops below a certain threshold. So you have to keep an eye on their renal function. Okay. I hope you found this helpful, and please comment your comments in the section below.